In order to support label printing from a transaction, the administrator needs to log into the Factory Track system and select the parameters option Transaction Set Maintenance. This displays a list of the transactions that are available, and the administrator should select the appropriate transaction, for instance receipts. If the transaction supports order types, then the Label Print Parameter button is at the bottom of the Order Type Parameters form, otherwise it's on the Transaction Parameters form. If the transaction does not support label printing, this button will be disabled. If the transaction supports label printing, then the administrator should click on the Label Print Parameters button and the Label Print Parameters form comes up. In order to turn on printing at all, then the Print Labels button must be selected. We then have choices to make as to which labels should be produced. The top box here contains the highest level item type label. So if we're doing a receipt, for instance, then if we want to print a label for each item that we receive, then we would select the label that we wish to use. In this case, I'm going to use one of our predefined labels called item.btw. We'd select the default printer that we want to use and how many labels should be printed. We then have the option to run it in quiet mode or in the foreground. If we run it in quiet mode, this means that these labels are produced automatically with no intervention allowed from the user. We also have the option to say, is a label printed for the item in container, which we'll look at in a second, and override user printer. If we say override user printer, then the default printer at the transaction level takes precedence. If we deselect that, then the user printer takes precedence if it is set. If the transaction consists of handling units, then it is possible to also print labels at a child, parent, or middle level for the handling units that are being processed. Again, for each of these, we can select the appropriate label we wish to use and a printer and the number of labels. I'm going to deselect the middle level. If we're going to be creating a handling unit structure, for instance, which has got a parent and a child, then we might wish to print the child and the parent level. For now, I'll just turn off the parent. So this means now that if I'm, in this case, I'm doing a receipt, if I receive an item and it's handling unit controlled, then I will get this label printed. If I'm performing a receipt and the item is not handling unit controlled, then I will get this label. If I want to get the item label and the handling unit label, then I would select this box here, which means that if I'm doing a receipt which consists of a handling unit, I will get not only the handling unit label, but I will also get the label for the individual item or items in the handling unit. I will then save this. And now when I do a receipt transaction, then the options to produce the labels should be provided to the user.